Hello and welcome to vlog number 26. This week I'm going to talk about my experience of coming to terms with the diagnosis of Parkinson's disease. This was suggested by my wife, but was also the subject of a comment from YouTube user Clusterhead Survivor. My diagnosis came officially in 2011, when my neurologist said to me, "If I were a betting man, I'd bet you have Parkinson's." Of course, I didn't take that on board, and you'd be forgiven for thinking that I was in the classic first stage of grief or loss, which is denial. So what was I grieving for? I was grieving for the loss of the life that I had before. I was grieving for activities such as skiing that I was no longer able to enjoy. I was in denial, but it's not as simple as that. I believe that my symptoms were due to a sensitivity to dental metals, although it is a difficult call to make. Many of the symptoms of mercury poisoning are also symptoms of PD. It's likely that a sensitivity to dental metals brought on my Parkinson's or accelerated its progress, according to a doctor in London that I consulted privately. She agreed with my neurologist's diagnosis and said that he was trying to soften the blow by wording it in the way that he had. So I think that's the point at which I accepted that I had got Parkinson's disease, although I think that subconsciously, deep down inside, I knew it a long time before that, and was simply clutching at straws by believing that my illness was due to something that was, potentially, reversible. I'd been ill for a long time prior to my diagnosis, but the waters had been well and truly muddied by a misdiagnosis of benign essential tremor back in the mid-1990s. I'd seen my mother's Parkinson's get progressively worse over the years, but I'm not sure if that fueled my denial or added to my subconscious knowledge that that is what was wrong with me. It wasn't just me that went through denial. My wife, who was at that stage my fiancée, was also in denial. I remember her telling me, tearfully, when trying to come to terms with it, that she was too scared to Google Parkinson's disease because she was frightened of what she might find. The next stage of grief or loss is supposed to be anger, but I don't recall ever feeling angry about having PD. I think that following on from denial, for me, came a sense of relief, that at least I now knew what had been wrong with me all these past years, swiftly followed by a calm acceptance. My wife, I think, was angry, and is still angry. Angry because we only met towards the end of 2010, just before my symptoms went through the roof, and she feels that we never had the chance of a normal life together, and that Parkinson's has changed everything. And so it has. Although there is no fixed order of the stages of grief, the next stage is supposed to be bargaining. I didn't really understand this stage at first, at least not by its title. This is the stage where you're going, "If only I hadn't had all that dental work done. If only I had sought a second opinion. If only." Personally, I think that I've done a lot of seeking of second opinions over the years. My only "if only" is, if only someone had listened to me, then perhaps my disease progression would have been slowed. But really, if only doesn't solve anything or make you feel any better. And so to the fourth stage, depression. It's hard to decide whether my low moods are or were a stage of grief or loss, or caused by Parkinson's medication that I was prescribed, I was warned that it could cause low mood, or are simply symptomatic of Parkinson's itself. Certainly I have been through some black days, and I think the only thing stopping me from ending it all is the love of my wife and my children. Since I had my deep brain stimulation operation, days like this have been few and far between, and much more a lack of motivation than a depression. Finally, there comes acceptance, and I believe I accepted my illness a long time ago. I accept that I have Parkinson's disease, I'm able to tell people that I have Parkinson's, and I'm able to talk freely about it in my weekly vlogs, which is very therapeutic, especially when I receive messages from people who have watched my videos and been helped by them. That gives me a feeling of purpose and worth, so thanks for watching. If you have any questions or have a topic that you'd like me to cover in future vlogs, just leave me a message in the comments and I'll do my best to respond. Have a great week. See you next Friday.